And well, what about a make? Let's flip things on the other side. And a make or two, you've shared some already, but is there anything else you'd like to share about a make along the way?
A make. I guess I'll a make that I go back to all the time. And again, it's on the athletic side, but it was, I learned that in the weightlifting world. So you make weight and then you have 24 hours until you compete. So I started to think, you know, weight, obviously they have weight classes. So weight is a big deal there. So I determined that I was going to figure out how to cut weight, almost like you hear wrestlers do things like that, because I had 24 hours to put it back on. But of course, you do it the wrong way. You feel like crap the next day. You don't do well. So I absolutely poured myself into that because I knew if I could master that skill, it would be very beneficial for me. And I got to the point where, and I promise you, this is all documented, so it sounds absolutely insane. When I tell people this, a lot of times they're like, you got to be kidding me. I lost 19 pounds in a 24-hour period of body weight, weighed in, and then the next day had gained all the weight back. Now, again, it's all water manipulation. I didn't lose, you know, 19 pounds of fat or, you know, anything crazy like that. But the discipline that it took, the planning up front, 12 weeks out, I started putting things into place to be able to accomplish this goal, read several books, talked to several experts. And what I mentioned all that is to even take it away from the athletic realm again and say, this is how I approach things on the business side as well. When there's something new that I'm trying to learn, I pour myself into it. I go find the books. I read the books. I reach out to the authors of the books and say, hey, can I get 15 minutes of your time? I've read your book. I loved it. And I had some questions. I subscribe to the Steve Jobs theory. If you don't ask, the answer is always no. Some people say, oh my gosh, the author would never return my call or my email or whatever. I'll tell you, in my case, most of the time they will. They're flattered that you read their book. They want to help you. They wrote the book for a reason. And so the actual execution and the discipline it took to accomplish that goal, I look back on that now when I'm trying to do something difficult where I'm facing some hurdles in my career, in business, et cetera, I look back and I can look back to that experience and say, gosh, if I did that, this, whatever this is in front of me, is a piece of cake, right? So if I could, you know, accomplish that goal, come on, this is a piece of cake. And it puts things in perspective quickly and I get right back on track.
Yeah, what a story. What a way to kind of reverse engineer what you wanted to do and go through the process and all of the planning and preparation. I mean, thinking about it was one 24-hour period, but you started conditioning for that 24-hour period 12 weeks in right. advance for 24 hours.
And even before that was, you know, the reading the books,
right.
and talking with the authors. And so this, and then practicing, you know, practice makes perfect, right? So I didn't just, you know, roll out of bed and decide I was going to do this and do it, right? So, and again, I mentioned that because you can apply those exact same types of principles to anything you're trying to accomplish in your personal life, in your career, et cetera, any goals you're setting, you know, do that. I talk about all the time, model expert behavior. Whatever you're trying to achieve, someone else has probably achieved something like it or similar. Find them. Find the book. Find that author. And I'm not saying you copy what, you know, copy someone. I'm not saying to do that. I'm saying replicate their behavior. You know, how did so-and-so go about accomplishing whatever it is, you know, that's similar to what you're trying to do? Gosh, talk to them, pick their brain a little bit. For me, I'll tell you, I've done that a bunch of times. When I started hosting my radio show, I did the same thing. I reached out to some nationally syndicated radio show hosts and got help because the first time I hosted the show, it was to say it was terrible would be a massive compliment. I mean, it was so terrible. I mean, it was really bad. And so I said, I have to get better at this. And so who can help me get better at this than someone who's already well accomplished in the field, right? And let me pick their brain and utilize some of their knowledge. And maybe they can steer me around some hurdles or some challenges that they faced early in their career.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, thanks for sharing. And it sounds like, I mean, the next question is about a multiplier, but that sure sounds like a multiplier. I don't know if you have another one to share, but like just thinking about like, wow, how that compounds and expands over time.
Yeah, 100% for sure. I'll mention it. I'll keep it short because I know we're running a little long here. But
you're fine.
Another multiplier that it's really good for in the entrepreneur business space. And you had mentioned earlier about like social media and things is the power of video. When I started doing videos a few years back, it absolutely exploded the Mr. Biz brand, my social media following, the business, absolutely exploded everything. And so the power of video is real. And all these, I did 100 videos in 5 months. Same thing. I poured myself into it. I studied, I figured out, you know, some key elements I need to share and things like that. I had my little Excel spreadsheet. I put out 100 topics and I made the plan. I'm going to do 20 videos a month for 5 straight months. And I did all of them, all 100 were live streams with my phone. Nothing fancy, not over engineered, not edited at all. And I think the feedback I got and the more feedback I got, it made me realize people enjoy the authenticity. It's not overly produced. It's me being real. There's self-deprecating humor in the videos because I screwed up and I'd say, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry about that. Let me start again. I'm tongue-tied today, you know, or whatever. And people would, you know, they appreciated the fact that it was real. It wasn't something overly scripted or things, but et cetera. But no matter what your business is, that is a way for you to get a leg up versus your competition, because more than likely your competition's not doing those things. And you could do this with a plumbing business. You know, I had a client that has a plumbing business. He said, I can't do videos. I said, sure you can. He said, what do I do them on? I said, what are the top 10 reasons that people call you? And I said, do a video. And like the one example we had, the very first video he did was how to light a pilot light on a hot water heater. He said, we get that call 10 times a week. I said, make a 4-minute video on how to light the pilot light on a hot water heater. You know, people will find that very helpful. And you know, that's the kind of thing you can do. Think outside the box, make those short videos, and it helps people get in touch with you. They understand your personality a little bit. They make that connection with you. Can this person help me or not? What exactly does their business do? You know, that kind of thing was super powerful. Absolutely a multiplier for sure.